Hello, my name is Matthew Ogle, and I am going to deliver today a brief lecture to you on design engineering careers for biomedical engineering students. So, if you refer to slide number 2 in my slide set, you'll see that after doing some research, I found out that graduates of your biomedical engineering program go on and about 50% go on to graduate school, 25% go into industry, and about 25% go on to be doctors and lawyers, professional degrees. So when looking at that demographic, we can go ahead and piece it down, and this is now slide 3. What I've done is taken it into 3 different elements: academic, career and pursuit, government, and business. And business meaning the real creation of commerce. So in academia, I chose this first because you're probably most familiar with this being in an academic institution. The first element is research. Everybody's pretty familiar with what you do as a researcher. The second element is teaching, and I believe a lot of you either have done a little bit of teaching or will TA, but everybody's been in a class, so you know what goes on with teaching. So the other, and I just wanted to point this out, and I'll try and, as I go through this, go through some things you might not have thought about when you're looking at career paths. One is technical or academic staff. A lot of people think that you have to either be a researcher or a teacher to be an academician. Academic staff is a great opportunity. If you don't want to write grants, you want to make a huge contribution, you can be sort of this technical person that works really well within an academic institution. So now on to slide 5, government careers. So these are 3 different areas. You need to really, you can do this either as an undergraduate or a graduate student or a postgraduate education. Regulatory, FDA, the EPA, or National Institute of Standards, NIST, all have arms. I'm most familiar with the FDA. I'm sure you'll hear another lecture about the FDA. I'm sure you'll hear another lecture about the standards agency. But they all have arms that you can get jobs in. The second sort of area would be patents and the patent office, U.S. Patent and Trademark Office. I've had a lot of dealings with folks from the Patent and Trademark Office. It's a great place to start your career and launch it. Spend 5 years at the Patent Office, and then you can go ahead and consult at different firms. You can even get into the patent business by spending the next 6 months of your life after graduating with a bachelor's degree, going ahead and studying for the patent bar, and then you become a patent agent. You can take the patent bar without even having a law degree. The third area in government is research. The FDA, the NIH, the DOE, the Department of Defense, and NASA all have research arms. You can go be a researcher at any one of those institutions. So that is government. Now I'll go into an area that I probably have the most experience, which is actual business. I spent 14 years of my life in business, actually the medical device business. The pathway to this is either graduate or undergraduate education, and it can be segmented into 3 areas: industry, finance, and the catch-all, consulting. Now, when I say industry, I mean actually the industry of making devices or making products, finance being the areas either accounting or financing these ventures. You have a rare opportunity as a biomedical undergraduate, as that you are one of the few majors that is actually a career. You can go ahead and do biomedical engineering right out of undergrad. There are only 2 or 3 other examples that I could think of, one being a teacher, a nurse, or maybe even an accountant, but no one else is prepared for this besides potentially biomedical engineering. So I'll quickly go through slide 7, but a lot of these areas, even in my short career of 14 years, have really blended together. For example, research. There are not really a lot of research departments anymore. They're all R&D, research and development. So that is where I started my career, in research and development. But then there is operations. And operations groups actually develop and manufacture products. quality, the last of what I would consider the first four technical disciplines in an organization, actually measures and through a series of systematic, organized steps, make sure that you have quality products going out the door. Regulatory deals with the FDA and the other agencies, and they do everything from making sure you can ship products outside the United States to getting approval in other areas. IT, when I started at St. Jude in 1994, we had five computers and they weren't even networked together. So now IT is a huge infrastructure, and even within every organization, and even bleeds into other things like sales and marketing. For example, you need to know the products in sales and marketing, making websites. So there's a whole new group in sales and marketing now called MarCom, Marketing Communications, which is IT-based. So all of these blend together. For example, now with sales and marketing, you spend 3 years in R&D, you go to sales and marketing, and you are on the front line working with physicians. One thing I will say about the biomedical engineering undergrads at this institution, I don't know if it's this institution or that it is students that are coming through are more charismatic, they're more personable. I think there are more opportunities in sales and marketing right now because they can interface. But that interface and some of the best jobs that I see are working with the physicians or customers and taking that information and rolling it right back into the research front end so you can have the best of all worlds in industry right now. The last element is management. If you like to organize, you like to be the boss and run a department, those are all opportunities. You need to do the groundwork to get to that level, but those are all opportunities. Finance, and I'll just briefly talk about this because this is one of the areas that I think is underlooked. Finance in three areas. Investment banking. So an investment banker is sort of like a real estate agent. They either help finance your house or business, or they help you sell it. So that is one area. Finance, I say, is probably the most lucrative business or element of the business you can get in. The other is an analyst. If you're a medical device engineer for 5 or 6 years, you write well, and you're intelligent and smart and know a lot about mathematics, you can go and write for Morgan Stanley, JP Morgan. You're probably going to need a little bit more of a business degree or be a really superstar in your field to get into that. The last is venture capital. I know a number of students that have come out of your program that have gone on to be venture capitalists. These are people that manage other people's money, invest them in early stage, mid stage, and late stage companies. Once again, I think that this is a great opportunity for people. And why do you think people in finance want people with engineering degrees? Because you are trained with a scientific method. You're very systematic. So don't overlook finance. The last bit of business is a consultant. And all I have to say is that with 7 years of experience and you're reasonably good at your job, there's probably a great chance that you can go be a consultant and live the life that you want to live and be a little bit more flexible. So that's what I'll say about consulting. The last slide, slide 10, go ahead and look at this slide. This is average salary and compensation. So these are the numbers that everyone looks for. So starting salaries for a bachelor's degree is $50,000 to $60,000. Very widely, depending on institution that you go to. A PhD, $70,000 to $90,000. If you go get an MBA and spend 2 or 3 years, you'll make as much as a PhD. General rule, 5 to 10 years, you'll double your salary wherever you start. The last is fringe benefits. You can expect fringe benefits to be about 35% of your total package of the numbers that I spoke about before. So that is the brief world of your potential career paths. I hope I gave you some useful information, and thank you for your time.